Hi everyone, and welcome to another episode of Fighting Evil by Booklight. Okay everyone, we are doing our TBR game, which is Fighting Evil by Booklight. So I'm just gonna introduce the game. So what we do in our game is we have 5 turns. So the first spin of that turn is to go to the genre card, which corresponds to each of the Sailor Scouts, or Tuxedo Mask, who has a special card. And the second spin is for the number. So basically, I pick a genre card, and then I pick the book corresponding to the number that is in the second spin. Then we go to the next turn, and next turn, and next turn. Now, I did mention that a Tuxedo Mask has his own card, and that card, it corresponds to the prompt, adding a book. So I have 5 books that I will spin and pick, but any turns that land on Tuxedo Mask will add an extra book to my pile. So Tuxedo Mask, we'll just have to see how he's feeling today. Quick wrap up from my last game. For those who do not want to hear the wrap up, skip ahead. But basically, I was able to finish 5 out of 6 of my books. One book I am choosing to DNF, and that is The SX Serpent. I just wasn't really getting into the book. However, all the other books I read. So basically, my favorites from that pile are Cat's Cafe, which is a lot of fun. And my second favorite from that pile was A Cat Story. Both cat books, very predictable that I would like them both quite a bit, but I recommend them for you. And they are also both graphic novels, so they are a quick read that you can get through in no time at all. Alrighty, you know what? I am just so jazzed to play this game. I am looking forward to it. I really hope that you are too. Let's see how many books we're gonna pick today. Tuxedo Mask, I am looking at you. All right, and let's start with turn number 1. Alrighty. So we have Sailor Mars, and I'm gonna check what Sailor Mars corresponds to because I think it is romance. Definitely corresponds to romance. So we have 6 contenders. Our first contender is Blood Like Magic. Number 2, A Lot Like Adios. Number 3, The X-Hex. Number 4, Affinity. Number 5, Always Never. And number 6, By the Book. Okay, so let's see what number we are going to pick. That is number 5. Number 5 is Always Never, and this is a graphic novel, and it just looks really, really cute. So I'm going to read a little bit about the synopsis for you. After 40 years of being madly in love, Anna and Zeno are finally retiring and giving their romance a chance to bloom while they both still have time left. A unique but relatable story told in reverse, with each chapter stepping further back through the decades of touch-and-go courting, showing both the heartbreaking moments that kept the two lovers apart and the beautiful moments that kept their flame alive. Oh my gosh, this is so cute! And I cannot wait to read it. Loving this so far. Okay, we have a great pick. All right, and let us go to book number 2. All right, so we are doing turn 2 with our first spin. All right, we are already adding a book. Thank you, Tuxedo Mask. Okay, so when we add a book, we have 6 different genres to pick from, and then I do another spin to see what book I get. I will show you exactly how that works. So the 6 options are either 1, a romance, 2, a cat book, 3, a manga or graphic novel, 4, a fantasy, 5, a thriller slash contemporary, or 6, nonfiction. All right, so let us do our next spin for the number. Number 5. Okay, number 5 is thriller slash contemporary. All right, we have 6 potential options. We have 1, The Kindest Lie, 2, Black Girls Must Die Exhausted, 3, Fight Club, 4, The Strangers, 5, The Last Confession of Autumn Casterly, and number 6 is To Paradise by Hanya Yanagihara. Okay, let us see what book it's gonna be. Okay, number 1, The Kindest Lie. All right, here it is. All right, so let's read a little bit about what The Kindest Lie is about. So I am just reading off the back different quotes from different readers. Race, class, family, and secrets are all on a collision course in Johnson's extraordinarily moving, timely read, a gloriously written, stunning heart scorcher about who we are and who we could be. This has been on my list for quite some time. I'm looking forward to it. All right, let us do our next spin for turn number 3. We have already added a book, so we will be reading at least 6 books. All right, next turn. So that is my favorite Sailor Scout, Sailor Pluto. And let us see what that will bring us to. Okay, Sailor Pluto, her card corresponds to fantasy. So we have 6 potential candidates. Number 1, witches steeped in gold. 2, lore. 3, she who became the sun. 4, blood-like magic. 5, gods of jade and shadow, and 6, afar. Alrighty then, let us do our next spin for the number. It is looking, at least from here, that this corresponded to number 3. So what was number 3? All right, so this is She Who Became the Sun by Shelley Parker Chan. All right, and this book is described as a Mulan meets the Song of Achilles type of book. A lot of people were reading this last summer, and for some reason I put it down for a moment, but I am picking it back up and I am excited to. So we are going to be reading She Who Became the Sun by Shelley Parker Chan for our book number 3. All right, so we are gonna get ready for turn number 4. You can't see her, but Olivia is completely controlling the camera. She's being really cute. She's laying down on the bed, like, so cute. Okay, turn number 4. It's gonna be another fantasy. Okay, so we already know who the contenders are, so let us just jump in and spin the number for the book. And if we get She Who Became the Sun again, we're gonna do another spin because we already have that book on our list. That is how this works. Okay. Number 3. Okay, we're gonna spin again. Number 3 again, so we're gonna spin another time. Oh my. Okay, number two. And number two is another book that I put down, but we are going to finish it finally. I don't have too much of it left, but I don't know, I might start reading it from the beginning again. We'll see. Lore by Alexandra Bracken. Now, this is described as follows. Every 7 years, the Aegon begins. As punishment for a past rebellion, 9 Greek gods are forced to walk the earth as mortals. They are hunted by the descendants of ancient bloodlines, all eager to kill a god and seize their divine power and immortality. Long ago, Lord Perseus fled that brutal world, turning her back on the hunt's promises of eternal glory after her family was murdered by a rival line. For years, she's pushed away any thought of revenge against the man, now a god responsible for their deaths. Yet, as the next hunt dawns over New York City, 2 participants seek her out. Castor, a childhood friend Lore believed to be dead, and Athena, one of the last of the original gods, now gravely wounded. So, from what I remember, this is set in present day, I believe. You know, I think that this is going to be one that I'm going to have to start from the beginning. Okay, so number 4, we are looking forward to this. Let me know if you have read Lore before and what your thoughts are. I'm going to try and listen to the audiobook at the same time. Okay, so let us finally finish this book. Oh, and there's Medusa. I think that's Medusa. Yeah. All right. Now we are going to do turn number 5. All right. So we are adding another book. So we're going to have at least 7 books. Yeah. And again, you know the drill. I'm going to spin again, see what genre, and then we're going to spin for the book. Okay. And start. 7 books. Number 2, which is a cat book. Okay, what are our cat books? Love a good cat book, always. So we have 6 contenders. 1, I Am a Cat. Number 2, A Cat, a Man, and 2 Women. Number 3, Pickles versus the Zombies. Number 4, Herding Cats. 5, The Eyes of a Cat. And 6, Cat versus Human Fairy Tales. Okay, now let us pick the book. Okay, that is number 1, which is a larger book. Okay. All right. This one is called I Am a Cat by Sosuke Natsume. 3 volumes in 1, of course. So this has been on my shelves for quite some time. Let me read a little bit about what it's about. So this is about a kitten who spends time observing human nature. So it looks like it might be a take on human nature from a cat's perspective. You know, I've heard a lot of people enjoy this one, and I think it will be a lot of fun. So this is book number 5 of at least 7 books. So Tuxedo Mask, let us chill out a little bit, and we will hopefully just have 7 books, but we'll see, okay? So let us do turn number 6, starting with our first spin. Okay, we have Sailor Moon, who corresponds to a graphic novel, one of my favorite categories. All right, and our 6 contenders are The Alchemist, Vagabond, Dragon Ball, Surviving the City, Cassandra, Animal Psychic, and Nichijou. All right, let's see what book we are going to get. Ooh. It is number 4. So this is a short book. It is Surviving the City number 1 by Tasha Spillett and Natasha Donovan. So it is a story about womanhood, friendship, colonialism, and the anguish of a missing loved one. Tasha, who is an Indigenous author, her work centers on land and water defense and the protection of Indigenous women and girls. And illustrations are by Natasha Donovan. I'm so looking forward to reading this. So now let us move on to turn number 7, which may be our last turn. Okay. She corresponds to the card romance. So we have 6 options, and we have gone through those options earlier. So we are going to do our next spin for our final book. Okay. So number 2, which is a lot like Adios, and this is by Alexis Daria. So she is the author of You Had Me at Hola. So this is a second chance romance, and it is between Gabe and Michelle. She is torn between keeping Gabe at arm's length or picking up right where they left off. So can they resolve their past mistakes? Or is it only a matter of time before Gabe says adios again? Okay, guys, so we have our 7 books. We have a graphic novel, which is called Always, Never. Then we have a fantasy, which is She Who Became the Sun. Another fantasy, which is Lore. We have A Lot Like Adios. Another graphic novel, which is A Surviving the City. From the thriller slash contemporary category, we have added The Kindest Lie, which I believe is a contemporary. And finally, we have our last added book, which is I Am a Cat. So we have 7 books. So it's gonna be a lot of reading, a little bit of refreshing with some of the books that I had already read. So we are just gonna have a blast of a time, and I'm excited for it. Whew, this is kind of heavy though. Okay, everyone, let me know out of all of those titles if you are looking forward to hearing about any of them. I do have a couple of other books I'm going to be reading. Of course, I will be reading my NetGalley books, which I'm going to be doing for review, which look out for those. I am loving my NetGalley books, and even during the game, I was auto-approved by a publisher, which has never happened to me before, so I'm so happy. And that is just everything for today, and maybe I'll sneak in, you know, a new release here and there if I get the chance to, but there's gonna be a lot of reading this month, okay guys? Let's go ahead, read onwards, and have a good reading month in July. Okay everyone, that is everything for today.